Geppetto thought for a moment and then said that they could try sending Pinocchio out on a mission. He was to go down to the village and buy some bread. Although Geppetto had no money, if he searched all his cupboards and pockets, maybe he could scrape together a few coppers, enough for a piece of bread. And once he had turned a pair of trousers in the wardrobe inside out and searched in the kitchen drawers, he found a few coins, which he gave to Pinocchio. "These are our last funds. Take care of them and go straight to the bakery, buy the bread and come back without taking any detours." "I promise," said Pinocchio, waving Geppetto goodbye. "Just follow the road down to the square and you'll find the bakery." Pinocchio was in a good mood as he walked down the street, whistling to himself. Every now and then he stopped and looked into shop windows, but not for long, because he had to show his dad that he could keep his promise and only do what he had been asked to do. But there was so much to discover. 24 hours ago, he had been nothing but a few chunks of wood.
To learn to be a real human being all at once wasn't easy, if you couldn't look around you and study everything in the village and what all those who were human beings did.
There ought to be people here who could afford to buy toys. Ladies and gentlemen strolled along arm in arm. Others sat in cafes or shop for hats, suits and dresses. And at the watchmaker's, you could get your watch repaired or buy a new one. Children ran around and played in yards, rolling hoops, playing hopscotch, or kicking a ball. Everywhere there was life and movement, and people cast curious glances at Pinocchio, since he looked more like a puppet than a person. "Oh, let them look. I don't care," thought Pinocchio, as he approached the square in the centre of the village.
"Oh, you stupid morons!"
He was just about to go through the door into the bakery when he heard a terrible noise.
"How dare you! I'm so sick!"
There was enough shrieking and bellowing coming from a building with a sign outside saying "Stromboli's Puppet Theatre," enough to make the window panes bulge.
"Get out now!"